In this next video, we're going to continue on and add costs into our schedule. So during this video, I'd like you to refer to pages 81 to 83 of the textbook. So the first thing we have to do is to go to the resource sheet again. So we're going to go to find the resource sheet and these are the six resources that we set up, but we didn't indicate their hourly rate. So you can find that on page 81. This can be either their actual rate in some instances, or it may also be their loaded rate. Reflects overhead and so on. So I'll just add each of those. When that's done, you just return to the Gantt chart. Now, nothing looks like it changed here. So what we need to do is to go and look at a different view. So I'm already set up on the View tab. Click on Cost Table. And then this changes the table, which is on the left side. And we can see that now costs have been associated with our schedule because it is now calculating based upon the allocations of resources. It's calculating the amount of costs that will be in each activity and adding it all up. So we're currently at 41,920, which isn't quite at the 56,520, which is our total cost in the textbook. So there's a few costs that we're missing. One of those costs is, again, if we return to the resource sheet for a moment, there are additional costs that are in our planning, which are the other costs at the bottom of page 83. You can see there's four different things there: banner stands, cards, murals, and camera tripods. So I'm gonna set up one at this point, the banner stands. So you just type in banner stands. Now these aren't work resources, they're a different type, which are material resources. According to our estimates, the unit cost of a banner stand for one is $200. So it depends on how many we're going to use. And then this material column is what you're going to call it in reports. So we're going to say that those are stands. And you would do that also for the holographic cards, murals, and camera and tripods. But I'm just going to go back to the Gantt chart at this point and see what we do with that. Now, the next step is we need to allocate those material resources to the activity or the place where it makes sense within the schedule. So again, I'm going to switch our table back to the entry table. And let's say that we have to pay for it as we order it. So it would make sense to attach that cost to the order banner stands. So if we double click on that, we find a new line, we find banner stands, and then it's asking for how many are there. Now again, if we check our estimates, we're estimating five. We press OK. Notice we've added five stands to that activity. We go back in just to take a look, we can see that $1,000 has been added to our cost. So our costs are now up by $1,000. So we keep doing that. We'll add the rest of the resources, the material resources. We'll assign them to the appropriate place in the schedule. And then if we were to do all that, it would look like this. I'll just switch to cost, and we're at, I'll just scroll up to the top, we're at 56,520. Now, one of the things I had to do, just to let you know, I had to add another task into our schedule of monitoring and controlling. If you remember during chapter 6 of the text, there was a reflection that or planning that the project manager would spend 34% of her time monitoring and controlling the project, and that the business analyst would spend 20%. So that was an additional cost that was going to add up to $10,000. And if we look at how that was done, I'll just go back to the entry, is that was done by defining a 25-day activity, and Jason was assigned 20% and Sophie was assigned 34%, which generates a $10,000 cost. So if we, sometimes those sort of overall costs are not put in the schedule, they're kept separately and added to the total cost. In this case, we inserted it into the schedule just so that the MS schedule could match exactly our overall cost estimates. So that's an introduction to entering costs into your schedule. We'll see you next time.